Micrognathia is a condition in which the lower jaw or mandible is smaller than usual. Micrognathia is typically congenital, meaning babies are born with it. It can occur on its own or may be part of certain genetic syndromes. Micrognathia is a feature in children with Pierre Robin sequence, a facial condition that forms before birth that results in an underdeveloped lower jaw, backward tongue placement, and a closed-off or obstructed airway. It is often associated with a cleft palate. Babies born with Pierre Robin sequence can have trouble breathing, feeding, and sleeping due to their unique anatomy. Normally, when a baby breathes in, air passes into the nose and mouth, past their tongue, and down their throat or airway to their lungs. In babies with micrognathia, an unusually small jaw causes the baby's tongue to rest further back in their airway. This may cause their airway to become obstructed, meaning they can have difficulty breathing, especially while sleeping. An airway obstruction is a serious condition that needs to be addressed immediately by their care team. Micrognathia and Pierre Robin sequence present differently in each child, and your child's care team will make a plan that fits their specific needs. Treatment plans can include monitoring, placement of an endotracheal tube for breathing, a tracheostomy tube, or mandibular distraction osteogenesis surgery. Mandibular distraction osteogenesis is a surgical procedure used to correct micrognathia. The goal of the procedure is to distract or lengthen the lower jaw and pull it forward. This pulls the tongue forward and out of your baby's airway. Mandibular distraction can help avoid long-term intubation or tracheostomy tube placement. The age that the procedure is performed can vary, but it is usually very early, in the first few weeks or months after birth. The surgery is performed in an operating room, and your baby will be asleep under general anesthesia. First, small cuts are made in the skin under the jawline. The distraction device is attached to either side of the jawbone using small screws. The surgeon will make cuts in the jawbone, called osteotomies, on either side to separate the front of the jawbone from the back. Small pins from the distraction device will stick out from the skin. Your baby will need to stay in the NICU in the days or weeks following surgery, as their surgeon gradually lengthens their jawbone. Beginning a few days after surgery, the distraction pins are turned 2 to 3 times a day. Each turn lengthens the distraction device by a small amount, 1 millimeter or less, creating a tiny gap between the jawbone pieces. This gap fills with new bone tissue and makes the jaw longer. Over the next few days or weeks, the jaw is distracted to its corrected length, pushing the tongue forward and opening the airway. The distraction device stays on for the next few months at home as the new jawbone hardens and heals. Once healed, the device can be removed in a follow-up surgery performed by your child's surgeon.